Hello, I'm Ty Mason of the DiabetesCouncil.com, researcher, writer, and I have type 2 diabetes. Today I'm going to answer the question, is coffee good for diabetes? But before we get into that, make sure you download my free diabetes management book, which also includes a diabetes grocery shopping guide, Foods to Eat and Avoid, by clicking the link below. Americans consume 7.3 billion gallons of coffee each year. Yes, that's billions with a B. But surprisingly, that's the fourth most consumed beverage annually in the U.S. Number one, well, that's soft drinks. Number two, well, not so soft drinks. And number three is bottled water. There are several studies that have been conducted over the years that have concluded that those who are regular coffee drinkers have a significantly lower risk of developing type 2 diabetes. Yet there are also many studies that show that those with type 2 diabetes have trouble controlling their blood sugar if they are regular coffee drinkers. What word do you think of when you think coffee? Well, most of you probably just thought, or maybe even said out loud, caffeine. Well, researchers thought the same thing recently when they decided to study the effects of caffeine on those with type 2 diabetes, not just coffee. They found that it is, in fact, the caffeine that causes the inability in many to control their blood sugar. The study was conducted by Dr. James Lane, who found that after given caffeine pills with meals, those with diabetes saw an 8% increase in their blood sugar compared to times when they were given a placebo. Lane remarked that this is a significant rise. But how can caffeine keep you from developing diabetes and also worsen the symptoms for those with diabetes? Well, it can't. And a Harvard researcher, Dr. Rob Van Dam, says it's not the caffeine in coffee that is preventing some from developing diabetes. In fact, Van Dam says it is possible that decaf coffee may actually help people with diabetes keep their blood sugar under control, whereas regular coffee has a damaging effect on blood sugar. But that has yet to be studied. Regardless of the reason, there is apparently something in coffee that can help prevent or possibly even control diabetes. But another fact is apparent. It is not caffeine. So is coffee good for diabetes? Well, no, it's not. Regular coffee is certainly not good for diabetes, period. And Dr. James Lane advises that those with diabetes not drink any kind of coffee. There is not enough research to back a claim that decaf coffee will help control your blood sugar. I hope this answers your question, is coffee good or bad for diabetes? Don't forget to get your diabetes management book by clicking the link in the description box below. And as always, let me know if you have any other diabetes-related questions. Thanks so much for watching. I'm Ty Mason.